clock down to 11. Five wide outs. Here comes a run. No, Shafnisky is going to be pushed backwards and slammed to the turf by DBY. Demetrius Baldwin, Youngblood, will drop him at the 31. They had five wide receivers, Kevin. I'm surprised nobody was open. At the 38, third and six for Bucknell, and the pistol is Laletta. Here comes a draw play. Big hole for Delmaro. He'll cut it free for a first down and more. He'll fight inside the Lehigh 30. Carry tacklers inside the 25 and be dragged down at the Lehigh 22-yard line by Rapanti. But, oh, my almighty, what a chasm that opened on the right side. And the shotgun blitz is on. Laletta rolls to his right. He's going to plant fire in. It's going to be caught inside the 5, twisting to the 2, all the way to the 1, into the end zone for 6. Bobby Kezlander, you're my hero. Touchdown! Your Bucknell Bison, Kezlander, fought from the 5 to the 3 to the 2 to the pylon. And with 27 on the first quarter clock, the play clock hadn't even started. Bucknell could not even choose to snap this ball if they so desired. They will. It'll be a good play action. Laletta goes deep down the middle. Here's Carter waiting for it. He has it at the 25. He has it at the 20. He has it at the 10. Ladies and gentlemen, WC is not WC Fields. He's WCTD. That is Willie Carter for 6. Touchdown! Your Bucknell Bison. Oh, my almighty. 69 and a score. Ball at the 29. Bucknell has to get it to the 31 of Bucknell. There's going to be a pass by Laletta. He is under pressure. He'll throw it short. It's going to be caught out of the backfield by Delmaro. He'll stutter step his way for a first down. He just kind of stutter stepped his way past the linebacker for the Mountain Hawks and found room up the near side to the 38-yard line before Condis could bring him down. But another big third down conversion for the Orange and Blue. It's third and about 16. Here is Shafnisky with time. Throws it over the middle. It's intercepted this time. Lee Marvel has it at the Lehigh 30. He cuts across the grain to the 20, and then he dropped down at the 17. Oh, my almighty. Lee Marvel. It's a marvel with his third interception, making his fourth in his career, second this year. Of course, Laletta can run, too, at the goal line, second and goal. Here's an all-out run blitz. Delmaro fights against it, pushes the pile forward. Touchdown! Your Bucknell Bison. Delmaro pushed the last little inch across for his second rushing touchdown of this year. Lehigh acted as if they were going to send their offense out, but they do have Devine out there, but it's a fourth and two. Low snap, Devine is going to throw it. He throws it, intercepted. It's intercepted at the 41. He threw it right into the hands that time of the Bucknell backup safety, Connor Golden. Bucknell was burned last week on a 4th-and-7 fake punt by Bryant. Today, Bucknell turns the tables with the first career interception by Golden. Oh, here's an all-out blitz. Laletta steps up against it. He'll roll to his right, and he's going to tuck it in and run. Here we'll come to the far sideline. He'll dive for the sticks, and I think he has it, Kevin. Oh, my almighty. He pumped after he got flushed out of the pocket, ran to the 30 on the far side, and he may have enough. And
oh, he's got it.
First and 10 Bison, Kevin. We'll see what crowd there is here, starting to cheer for the Mountain Hawks. Bauer, an 18-yard field goal. Placement is down, kick is up, and it splits the uprights. Good. 18 yards out. That will end this first half, and Bucknell will score again at the end of a first half.
And I know Coach Susan wasn't overly ecstatic about just getting 3 points with that short field on that last drive, but I'll tell you what, that becomes a lot more points if you can turn this one into 7 at least.
Not a doubt there at all. And the pistol is Trey Laletta. They'll come with pressure, and they'll throw a screen near side to Carter. Here he comes up the sideline to the 30, to the 40, to the 50, to the 40 of Lehigh, to the 20, to the 10. Yes, indeedy. WC does it again. Willie Carter, you are the man. Touchdown! Your Bucknell Bison. You are waving bye-bye at the 30 of Bucknell.
Listen, that was the first time all game that Lehigh did not have three guys out there for that wide receiver screen.
But the 17, first and 10, Lehigh down 31-7. Man in motion. Looks like Pelletier. It'll be a draw by Shafinski. Here he comes to the 10, or the 15 rather, and he's dragged down right at the 15. Third and 7 for Lehigh at the Bucknell 14 after the fumble. Here comes Shefnisky, back to pass. He has time. Now he's going to roll to his right. He's under duress. Now he's going to tuck it in. Throw it, man, is open. It's intercepted. He threw it against the grain of his body. And Bedolas comes up with the pick at the 8-yard line. And Coach Susan said, if we can make Lehigh one-dimensional, I don't think Shefnisky can beat us with his arm. He had, and that's his second pick today. So I tell you what, Kevin, I think they are playing the run so much that I think Will Carter could get deep again. It's 2nd and 8.
Well, it's almost time to give that a shot. I mean, I think you're right on that, Doug, because they have really played everybody within 5 yards of the line of scrimmage. Even the receivers, our corners, are starting to play up and playing bump and run man-style coverage or cover zero.
And Buckdell's Laletta making his first start of the year did a good job in terms of play action before.
And there it is, man-to-man coverage on Carter as the safety comes to the middle of the field.
Offset eye, play clock at 2. Here comes Laletta, pumps, now goes deep, man is open, it's Carter, he has it at the 40, has it at the 30, has it at the 20, at the 10, at the 5, see you later, big guy! Willie Carter burns him again, Kevin, touchdown! Your Bucknell Bison, how do they let Will Carter get deep on the pump and go? First and 10 at the 21. Shefnisky in, the crowd a little bit more quiet now. In the shotgun, he plants, he is under duress, he'll be dragged down inside the 15 at the 10. Bucknell expecting pass, and Clay Yule comes back there, along with who else back there for Bucknell? Jimmy King at the 12, 2nd and about 20, low snap. Here's Shefnisky, throws it over the middle, it's intercepted! There comes Marvel, down the far side to the 20, and he gets blasted at the 16. But another pick, the 3rd of the day against Shefnisky, and the 2nd today by Lee Marvel, who'll run over and hand the ball to the official as he's taught by Coach Susan. And Bucknell now within 5:03 of getting a 2-game winning streak against Lehigh forever, 38-24 Bison. You know, I don't know, you're torn here. You don't want to rub it in. If you take a knee, Lehigh still has to go 99 yards.
Well, and that's the thing. If it's 42 seconds to go, I think you might consider it. I think here you have to call a play that gets you in the end zone and puts the game away, because you just, the way this game's going, you don't want to take a chance.
Let under center. 4th and goal at the 1, handoff Del Morrow. He'll skip to the 2, spin to the 1, touchdown! Your Bucknell Bison. Del Morrow spun his way from about the 1-foot line, and Bucknell scores 40 points or more against Lehigh in back-to-back years. Right now, they're just...
I don't remember seeing anything about it.
90 seconds from that. Here comes a pass, and it's going to be picked! The receiver fell down at the 31. That was Paris, and coming up, I think, was Connor Golden to pick it off. Or no, was that
no,
Clay
that
Yule?
That was Clay Yule.
His 4th interception this year. Now, Bucknell is going to go to 5-1. Lehigh going to fall to 0-5. As Bucknell going to win this one 45-24.